If you're using Office 365 for small businesses, you may be looking for different ways to make it easier to encourage, well, both yourself and your employees and coworkers to start using the Teams site and saving documents to your Teams site, which is on SharePoint Online. The default document library looks something like this, and this is where you store your documents. Typically, to add documents to this, you can either upload individual documents by using the dialog here and browsing to them, or upload multiple files, drag and drop those files in. And both of those are easy ways to add documents to the document library. But what if you want to work directly out of Word, for example, save a document and then save it straight to your Office 365 Teams site? There's no real easy way to do that. So what I want to show you today is a way to show that information inside of programs like Word. You can browse to the document library on your site, and either you can copy the address, which I'm doing here in the address bar, from your browser address bar, copy that, and then when you switch back to Word and create a new document, just click Save, and then in the Save As dialog box here, just paste in that address up to the document's location. Another way you can think of it is just simply typing your website address followed by slash team site slash documents. That's the default document library on your team site. Now that we've added in that path to the top, we see all of our documents on folders on our SharePoint site. So with the location up here highlighted, just right-click on Favorites and choose Add Current Location to Favorites. Now it's going to come in with something kind of a generic-looking name here, like Documents. So I want to rename that to something that I will recognize in the future, like My Office 365 Documents. And then I'll give it a name here. And click Save. I'll choose the content type, Word, that's fine. And that's all there is to it. If you, the next time you create a new document in Word, Excel, or PowerPoint, or any of the other Office programs, create a new document, click Save, and now we'll see our Office 365 site located here. Double-click it, and once again, we can add them here, or add them to our individual folders and libraries we have there. And that's it. That's the trick I want to show you today.